Tinplate Girl.
Folding and forming are ways of creating three-dimensional objects out of two-dimensional pieces of metal. By learning a few simple techniques, you'll be able to create a vast number of three-dimensional shapes, some of them quite complex. The folding and forming steps of your projects are where you can really start to see a project take shape and come to life. There are lots of ways to do this type of work. What I'll show you in this video are methods that we use in our projects and that I've found to work for me. Because tinplate is tempered when it's manufactured, it's relatively hard and can't be stretched or shrunken very much. For this reason, it's generally not good for making compound curves, though this can be done on a limited basis. However, for most of our projects, we'll just be making simple bends. One thing you should be aware of, though, is that tinplate from different sources will have different characteristics. Some will be extremely stiff, and others will be almost buttery as you start to work it. One of the easiest ways to form tinplate is with pliers. The types of pliers I use most often include needle nose, flat nose, and round nose. I prefer pliers that have no teeth because they won't mark the work. Each type of pliers is used in a different situation. Needle nose pliers are generally used when clearances are tight. Flat nose pliers are good for general bending. Round nose pliers are useful for making curved bends and small cylinders and cones. Pliers are also used for bending the brass rods that we use in a lot of our projects. Flat nose pliers are good for square bends, while round nose pliers can be used to make hooks and eyes. To use the jaws of your pliers to make a bend, make sure that the edges of the jaws are actually straight. To make the bend on a small piece, align your fold line with the jaws, then simply fold the tin plate over with your fingers. The jaws of your vise should have smooth upper edges and, preferably, be without teeth or serrations on the gripping surfaces. The bigger your vise, the better. To fold a piece of tinplate in the vise, simply grip it in the jaws, carefully aligning the dotted line on your pattern with the top of the jaws, then bend the piece over with your fingers. If you want a really sharp corner, you can tap the folded edge with a block of hardwood and a hammer. If you find that the piece is too small or difficult to fold with your fingers, you can use a block of wood. Either push the wood into the work at around a 45-degree angle to get the fold started, or tap the block with your hammer. Then use the block to form the piece the rest of the way. If your vise is too small for the project you're working on, you can make some simple vise extenders. Our free downloadable PDF will show you how. Vise extenders simply expand the capacity of your vise jaws. However, they may not grip as firmly as your vise. Also, if you're gripping something thicker than a layer of tinplate, like a wooden form, you'll have to use a spacer of equal thickness at the bottom of the extenders for them to work properly. Several of our projects call for the use of wooden forms. These can be easily made on your table saw, radial arm saw, or even a chop saw. These pieces need to be very carefully cut so that they exactly match the patterns that have been designed to work with them. Instructions on how to use the wooden forms are clearly covered in each project that calls for them. Sometimes the projects call for curving a piece of metal. One of the best ways of doing this is by forming it with your fingers over a piece of dowel, rod, or pipe held in the vise. To avoid kinks and sharp bends, hold the piece taut, then work it from side to side on the dowel as you're bending it. The final bend should always match the bending guide provided in the drawing. For making tighter curves on smaller pieces, sometimes it helps to start at one end of the piece, smoothing the metal over the dowel with your fingers as you go. You can also grip the metal in your vise with a dowel sandwiched between it and the vise jaws. Then, bend the metal around as far as you can, reposition the work and the dowel in the vise, and continue until the curve or cylinder is complete. Your vise and your pliers are great for making 90-degree bends, but what if you want a sharper angle? Good question. The way you do this is to start the bend in the vise, taking it as far as you can. Then, remove the work from the vise and press the folded part against your work surface, applying even pressure along its length. In this way, you can make a fold of any angle up to 180 degrees. If you are making a 180-degree fold, tap the folded edge with your hammer and a wooden block for a really nice edge. Alternatively, you can crimp it in your vise. Some of our projects, like this mailbox, call for forming a curved edge over a wooden form. While this is explained in the projects, seeing how it's done will make more sense. Sandwich your tin plate between two identical wooden forms in the vise, with the part to be formed sticking out. With your small hammer, gradually tap the protruding edge over a few degrees at a time, going back and forth to evenly bend the entire edge. You may need to turn your work in the vise as you move along the edge to form the sides evenly. As you go, you'll find that the tin plate wants to wrinkle up on you. That's okay, but try to keep the wrinkles as small as possible. This might take a little practice. The wider the folded edge, the more it will want to wrinkle. As the edge is more nearly formed, tap the wrinkles flat against the form with your hammer. You'll be surprised at how many you'll be able to tap out entirely. Any slight ones that are left can be smoothed over with a file. So as you can see, there are a number of straightforward ways of making both simple and complex bends. After you've worked with tinplate for a little while, you'll get a feel for the material, with its quirks as well as all of its great qualities.